This is Jarrod Horak for today's racingdigest.com, and my today's Racing Digest video series continues Saturday, November 17th, 2018. We're going to do the eighth race from Delmar. It's going to be the Grade 3 Bob Hope Stakes for two-year-olds, and they're going to be traveling 7 furlongs on the main track, and we have a 7-horse field. And let's pull up the today's Racing Digest race header, and let's look at the track profile for 7 furlong races at Delmar, and we will see that front runners and pressers win the bulk of the races at this distance at Delmar. Let's jump over to line 7 in the race header. And in line 7 is the running styles of the horses. And there are two horses designated with the letter F. That letter F stands for front runners. And those two front runners in this race are Mucho Gusto and Savagery. So those horses could set a decent pace if they hook up early. It could set up for an off-the-pace runner. If one of those horses gets loose, they could be tough to catch. But I think that one of the horses that's going to sit directly behind those two and get a jump on the late runners in here is going to be my top choice, and that's going to be number 6, Sparky Ville. He's got that good tactical speed, and I think that this is a good distance for him, and he drew well as well. This one is a gelded son of Candy Ride. He was okay in his summertime starts this year, but never really looked like he was going to be a stakes winner. But then he was laid off. He returned as a gelding. That was at Santa Anita Park on October 21st in the restricted Sunny Slope Stakes at 6.5 furlongs. He stalked the pace in that 4-horse field, and he was able to win nicely. He earned solid today's Racing Digest numbers across the board. He earned an improved 82 fire number, a 115 CPR, a 128 pace rating, and a 122 final rating. For those not familiar with the today's Racing Digest numbers, the fire number is speed throughout a race. The CPR, the comprehensive performance rating, takes into account pace, final time, and closing fraction. So Sparkyville earned improved ratings under Gary Stevens last time out. I think he's going to set a great trip in this race. Maybe the only negative is that he's done his best work at Santa Anita, and this is at Delmar, but he's never been better. He's on the improve. Certainly looked very professional as a gelding last time out, and he should get the first run in here. The horse that I like second best in here, it was a tough choice between my top two. I did make Sparkyville my top choice, and my second choice is the 2, Extra Hope. He's 7-2 morning line. He's another one that improved, and the reason that he improved probably last time is they put the blinkers on, and he broke his maiden at Santa Anita in a dirt route. That was on October 21st, the same day as the Sunny Slope Stakes, and he ran fast as well. He earned improved today's Racing Digest numbers. He got an 86 fire number, a 129 CPR, a 129 fire rating. So he earned some good numbers in that race, and now he's going to cut back in distance to 7 furlongs. A lot of times horses that can go a mile and a 16th, a mile, around 2 turns, they cut back to 7 furlongs. They can handle that. I like the fact that he had that he finished up nicely in his debut race. That was on August 4th at Delmar. And that was a sprint. So he's run well in a sprint. He's run well in a route. He's in that in-between distance now. And he also has a bullet workout at Delmar on November 9th. Flavian Pratt is going to ride for trainer Richard Mandela. Mucho Gusto will be my third choice. He's 5-2 morning line. And he could be any kind of runner for trainer Bob Baffert. He was the even money favorite in his debut at Los Alamitos Racecourse on September 20th. He showed good speed and he won nicely, getting a 134 pace rating and a 114 final rating. He's going to have to run faster in here. But do note that 2 runners from that debut race were next out winners. They paid $625,000 for this horse. They expected him to be good. He's probably going to be better than he was in his debut. Very inexperienced. We'll have to see how good he is. Joe Tellemer is going to ride back for Bob Baffert. They're a 10-for-42 combination. Number 4, Savagery. We mentioned him as one of the pace factors in here. He dropped into a maiden claiming $62,500 race at Delmar. Over the summer and on August 15th, and he broke his maiden by 11 lengths. He got a 131 pace rating, a 116 final rating. Very close numbers to Mucho Gusto. And then last time out in the Sunny Slope, he had the outside post in that compact field. He was up on the pace, but he was no match for Sparkyville in that race, and he ended up finishing a decent second. And his numbers were solid, 137 pace, 117 final. The fact that Mucho Gusto's in here could hurt his chances early on, and he's going to have to improve a bit to win this one. Owning number 5, he's 15-1 morning line. He broke his maiden in his debut at Los Alamitos, and then he faded in the Grade 2 Best Pal Stakes, and then he was off the board in a turf route last time. He's taking blinkers off, and he's moving back to a dirt sprint, and he is also reconnecting with his winning rider, Mario Gutierrez. Number 7, Sueno. He was beaten by 11 lengths or more than 11 lengths by Savagery in his local debut. And then he improved at 5.5 furlongs at Del Mar to break his maiden in a maiden claimer on August 31st. He's going to have to run faster. Finally, number one, Metropole. He won his debut as the heavy favorite against three rivals. That was in his debut for trainer Bob Baffert on October 8th. He's worked out for this. He's had four workouts. Drayden Van Dyke was gonna ride him, but now late word has come in that he's got a fever and he's probably gonna scratch out of this race. So here's how we're gonna play the Grade 3 Bob Hope Stakes. Sparkyville, my top choice, number 6, a win wager on him. We're gonna play a Quinella, the 6 Sparkyville with the 2 Extra Hope, the 3 Mucho Gusto, and then a trifecta. We're gonna put the 2 and 6 on top. Extra Hope, Sparkyville, and then we're going to stick Mucho Gusto in third and four, in second and third. That trifecta is 2-6 with 2-3-6 with 2-3-6. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can make some comments in the comment section. Who do you like in the 2018 Bob Hope Stakes? You go over to todaysracingdigest.com if you want the complete digest for Del Mar for Saturday, November 17th. And also my full cards are available each and every day from Del Mar at todaysracingdigest.com. That will wrap up this week's video. We'll be back next week with another stakes race from around the country.